Hello friends, welcome to today's session. Myself Jalaja Sajeev, PGT Bio from KV Keshapuram. Today's content is regarding cell cycle and cell division. First of all, to the introductory session, which is the life activity that leads to continuity of life. Without that life activity, not even a single species is able to continue its life. You know the answer? Yes, of course, it is the reproduction. And you know, in reproduction there are two different types. What are the two different types of reproduction? Again, your answer is correct: sexual and asexual reproduction. What is the mechanism of reproduction that is seen in a unicellular organism? Yes, it is with a cell division. You know, for linking one generation to another generation, there needs a single cellular and diploid structure, and that will act as a vital link. So, what is that vital link that links one generation with the other generation? You know, it is zygote. Again, you know the phenomenon of formation of zygote. Which phenomenon or which process that results in the formation of zygote? Yes, fertilization, fusion of male and female gametes. Is there any other term for this? Yes, syngamy. Now, how many cells are there in a zygote? There is the fusion of male and female gametes, two cells are fusing. So, how many cells will be there in a zygote? Yes, your answer is right, only one cell. How a zygote then develops into a multicellular organism? An interesting fact, it is only by cell division. Without cell division, zygote can't give rise to a multicellular organism. How the body of an organism grows? You consider your own case, you yourself developed from a single celled zygote and now the grown up body. So, how the body of the organism grows? Of course, it is by the phenomenon again cell division. Which life process leads to repair and regeneration of damaged tissues? If there occurs any damage in any of the tissues, then it must be repaired. And you know, in of the organism, some of the parts are regenerated, the lost body parts are regenerated. And the phenomenon here also, it is cell division. Is cell division occurs in sexual and asexual reproduction? Yes, of course, for asexual as well as sexual reproduction, there needs the phenomenon cell division. Now, coming to what is cell division? Cell and division, that means division of a cell into two or many daughter cells. The basic process involved in cell division: one, cell growth, that is synthesis and duplication of the components of the cell. Second, cell division. Adult cell that will divides into two daughter cells. Now coming to the different types of cell division. One is A mitosis, the other is mitosis, third one is meiosis. So, how many different types? Yes, three different types of cell division: A mitosis, mitosis, and meiosis. Now, coming to the stages of a cell division. It is not a simple phenomenon, it is not a single stepped process, but it consists of different steps. We can include these different steps into two major headings. One is karyokinesis. Karyon means nucleus, kinesis means division. So, karyokinesis means division of nucleus. The second phenomenon, that is called as cytokinesis. Again, cyto refers to cytoplasm, kinesis means division, so it means division of cytoplasm. Here, the first phenomenon for division, each and every cell has to undergo cell cycle. Cycle, cyclic events, series of events. The series of events, cyclic events by which a cell prepares for cell division. And this particular series of cyclic events by which a cell prepares for cell division, that is known as cell cycle. Now, what are the different steps in a cell cycle? The first phase we can call it as interphase. Second phase is known as M phase. Here you can see the picture of a cell cycle. It consists of again different stages. The interphase, the stage between two cell divisions, where the cell is preparing for cell division. So, it is not a resting stage, it is not a metabolically inactive stage, whereas it is a preparatory stage, and by this stage the cell is preparing for cell division, and it is a metabolically very active stage. Commonly, it is known as a resting stage. It is a misnomer. It is not a resting stage, it is metabolically highly active stage. And it is the longer stage in the cell cycle. It will last for about 95% of the cell cycle. So, this particular stage we will call it as interphase. Now, coming to the different stages of interphase. Here you can see the diagram: G1 phase, then S phase, then comes the G2 phase. G1, S and G2, collectively known as the interphase. Then again, when you are observing this diagram, you can see that after these three stages, G1, S and G2, there comes yet another phase that we will call it as M phase, with different steps such as prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, followed by cytokinesis. And here there is one more stage represented, that is G0 phase. Some of the cells even after this preparation, they are entering back to G0 stage, quiescent stage, remains inactive. So, in short, an endophase which consists of three different stages, G1, S and G2. So, these three stages or phases together known as the endophase. Now, coming to the first one, G1 phase. G represents what? Yes, gap phase or growth phase. Gap 1 phase, it is the post mitotic phase. This is M phase or mitotic phase, again G1. So, it is post mitotic phase. Or S, you see here in the in this cell cycle, here you can see S phase, and before this S phase, what you can see? Yes, G1 phase. So, this G1 phase, that is known as pre-synthetic phase. So, synthetic S refers to synthetic phase. So, before that synthetic phase, it happens. So, it is known as pre. Pre means before. Pre-synthetic phase. It is also known as growth phase. G1 phase, G4 again growth, 1 first. So, it is known as the first growth phase, and again it is the period between mitosis and DNA replication. During this S phase, there occurs DNA replication, and mitosis or M phase, the stage between M phase and DNA replication phase, S phase. What are the events that takes place during this stage? You see here enzymes and proteins. Some of the proteins and enzymes that are synthesized during this stage. Similarly, synthesis of RNA molecules, carbohydrates, lipids and pooling of amino acids and nucleotides. By using these amino acids, it can make the nucleic acid molecule, that means different types of RNA is synthesized. Then coming to the next point, that is when all these things are synthesized in a cell, naturally the size of the cell will increase. Of course, the size of the nucleus will also increase. A cell in the G1 phase can undergo any of the three options. First option can enter into the next stage. What is the next stage? S phase, and then it can divide. Second option, it may be arrested at any specific point in the G1 phase itself, it can be stopped. The third option is, it may stop cell division and it can enter into G0 stage, and that G0 stage is known as quiescent stage, inactive stage. These cells can again enter back to G1 stage, and it can start just like that of a normal cell depending upon the requirements. So, a cell in G1 phase can adopt any of the three options. Now, coming to the S phase. S for synthetic phase, synthesis. What is synthesized here? Yes, DNA is synthesized, DNA replicates, DNA gets doubled, each chromosome has then two chromatids. Then in addition, there needs some of the other basic proteins, for example, histone. So, synthesis of that basic proteins, mainly histone, will also take place during this synthetic stage, S phase. Chromosome number remains the same, even though the chromosome get doubled and each chromosome has two chromatids, the number of the chromosome remains the same. Now, coming to the next stage, that is G2 stage, second gap phase or gap second phase, second growth phase also, it is correct. And it is the stage that is coming after the synthetic phase, so known as post synthetic phase. And this is G2 phase. When you are observing this particular diagram, you can see that it comes before the M phase or mitotic phase. So, we can call it as pre-mitotic phase. Synthesize spindle proteins, the proteins needed for the formation of spindle fibers that are synthesized during this stage. Moreover, there is the synthesis of different types of RNA molecules. Synthesis and storage of ATP molecules, duplication of the centrioles as well as the different organelles needed for cell division, increase in the size of the nucleus. So, by the synthetic activities, the size of the nucleus and size of the cell will increase. Now, coming to the next phase, that is M phase, M for mitosis, mitotic phase, or even division phase. It is the stage, you can see here, comes after these three phases. What are the three phases? G1, S and G2. You know what term we will give for these three phases together? Yes, of course, it is interphase. So, it is the stage that is coming after this interphase. So, stage that follows interphase, that is the M phase or mitotic phase. And during this stage, M phase, you can see that the nucleus will divide, followed by division of cytoplasm. So, that division of a nucleus, we will call it as karyokinesis, and division of a cytoplasm, we will call it as cytokinesis. Now, coming to the duration of the cell cycle, whether all the cells are having same duration? No, it varies. It varies from cell to cell, and it also depends upon some of the external factors such as temperature, food, and even oxygen supply. Now, here are some of the examples. Bacterial cell, the duration of cell cycle is 20 minutes. When it comes to human cell, the average is 24 hours. Yeast cell, it goes to 90 minutes. And the intestinal epithelial cell, it goes to 8 to 10 hours. So, the cell cycle duration, that will vary from cell to cell. Here comes yet another type of cell division, amitosis. It is a simple method of cell division, or it is known as direct cell division. There is no synthesis of spindle fibers. There is no coiling and condensation of chromatin fibers. Nucleus elongates and divides into two. Nucleus of the particular cell that undergoes a mitosis, it will elongate and divides into two. And after this nuclear division, it is followed by division of cytoplasm. And this type of cell division, it takes place in the primitive type of organisms mainly, for example, bacteria, yeast, amoeba, and it can even takes place in the cartilage cells. So, it is the simplest method of cell division, or even direct method of cell division. We can call it as direct cell division, followed by elongation of nucleus and then followed by division of cytoplasm. Here is the method, you can see nucleus, it elongates and divides into two by the division of cytoplasm. Now, coming to the mitosis. The term mitosis that was coined by W. Fleming, discovered by Strasburger in plant cell and W. Fleming in animal cell. It takes 30 to 3 hours to complete. In human somatic cell, it takes 3 hours. It takes place in somatic cell or even in body cell. So, the cell division that takes place in the somatic cell or in the body cell, that is known as mitosis. It is known as equational division. Why it is known as equational division? Because here, after the cell division, we will get two daughter cells, and these two daughter cells are qualitatively as well as quantitatively remains the same. Moreover, the chromosome number regarding the DNA content, chromosome number and all, it will remains the same as that of the parental cell. So, this particular division, mitosis, it is known as equational division. It helps in growth, repair and regeneration. Here comes to the stages of karyokinesis. Here also the cell will divide by karyokinesis followed by cytokinesis. The different stages of karyokinesis, you know what is karyokinesis? Yes, it is the division of nucleus into two. The different stages here are prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. So, here there are five different stages: prophase, prometaphase, then metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Here you can see some of these diagrams also. Prophase stage, and this is the metaphase stage. In between these two stages, prophase and metaphase, there is a short stage, a transition stage, that is called as prometaphase. This is the anaphase stage and this is the telophase stage. Now, we can see what happens in each of these stages, what are the changes, what are the events that takes place in each of these stages of karyogenesis. First one, that is prophase. Here you can see the diagram. Go through this diagram and try to identify the changes, the events, the characters. First one, disappearance of centrosphere. Centrosphere, you know what is centrosphere? The area, the clear area that surrounds the centrioles. So, that centrosphere area disappears. Then what happens to this centriole? What is this particular structure? Centriole. What happens to the centriole? It gets doubled. Centriole pairs doubled and it get moving to opposite poles. It started moving to opposite poles. You can see very clearly in this diagram movement of the centrioles. Now, from each of these centrioles, you can see some of the rays, fibers, they are originating and we will call these as astral rays around the centriole. The astral rays start developing and these are the proteinaceous microtubules. Now, what happens to this chromatin reticulum? Chromatin reticulum that undergoes two phenomena. One is coiling. You know, when a structure coils, it gets condensed. So, it undergoes coiling and condensation to form chromosomes. Now, each chromosome, when we are observing, we can see that it has two chromatids. I'll show you here the diagram also. Here you can see the chromosomes. Each of these chromosome has two chromatids. And this chromatin reticulum seen in the resting phase or even in the interphase that undergoes coiling followed by condensation and they forms the thick rod shaped structures, we will call them as chromosomes. Each chromosome there is two chromatids and here you can see these two chromatids, they are seen attached at the centromere. And during this mid prophase stage, mid phase of the prophase, chromosomes undergo further coiling and condensation. Again, the chromosomes undergoes coiling and condensation, that process continues. And finally, it becomes a thick and rod shaped structure. Here you can see in the later phase of this prophase. And compare this one with the early prophase stage. There is huge difference. Here these are appearing as even thread like structure, but here it becomes highly condensed, the thick rod shaped structure. We can call this as chromosomes. And clearly you can see the chromatids, distinct chromatids you can see clearly. So, they becomes more and more thicker and they becomes shorter. And such thick and rod shaped chromosomes we can see here in the late prophase. Now, what happens to this nuclear membrane? Here you can see an intact nuclear membrane in the early prophase stage. But what happens in this late phase? You see, go through this diagram, the nuclear membrane that starts disappearing. It can be seen represented here as a dotted line only. Here it is an intact line in the form of a definite circle. So, here the nuclear membrane starts to disappear. Now, see these two diagrams, what happens to the nucleolus here and nucleolus here? In the early prophase stage, when you are observing, you can see here the nucleus, clear nucleus, you can see it is visible. But what happens to this in the late prophase? You can see here as the dots only. It means it is disintegrating, going to starts to disappear. Now, in a late prophase, there occurs further coiling and condensation of the chromosomes. I have already told you this coiling and condensation of the chromosomes, it is a continuous phenomenon and it goes on. And finally, we will get a highly thickened rod shaped structures with the two clear chromatids, we will call them as chromosomes. Now, you can see the asters. What happens to these asters? The centriole with astral rays, they have reached the opposite poles during the late prophase stage. Formation of spindle fibers. Again, you see, compare these two diagrams. Here, formation of spindle fiber starts. Here, it is almost completed. You can see here the spindle fibers that is connecting with these chromosomes. So, formation of spindle fibers takes place. Asters and the spindle fibers, we will collectively call it as mitotic apparatus. You can see here the labeling, centriole, the rays, that is aster, and here you can see the well developed spindle fibers. So, this aster plus spindle fibers, we will collectively call it as the mitotic apparatus. Now, when we are observing, here we can see that there are different types of spindle fibers. One is the chromosomal or discontinuous fibers, the other is continuous or interpolar fibers. Here you can see these different types of spindle fibers. You see, some of these spindle fibers, they are attached with this centromere of the chromosomes, and some are moving from one pole to the other, from one centriole to the other without touching these chromosomes. So, such fibers, the spindle fibers that are attaching with the centromere of the chromosome, they are known as chromosomal fibers. Here also you can see the chromosomal fiber, and in between these two, there is at another one, that is the interzonal fiber. It will link the centromere of one chromosome with the centromere of the other chromosome, interzonal fiber. And at the same time, the third one, that is continuous fibers, moving from one pole to the other, one centriole to the other continuously without attaching the centromere of these chromosomes. So, continuous fibers extend from one pole to the other. Here you can see continuous fibers, that is moving from one pole to the other. So, they are called as interpolar fibers. Inter means in between. So, in between the two poles, in between the two centrioles, you can see this particular fiber moving. So, it is known as interpolar fibers. Now, here the other one, that is called as discontinuous fibers. They will extend from pole and connect with the centromere or chromosome. They are extending from pole and they will connect with the centromere of the chromosome, this one. They are known as discontinuous. So, since they are connected with the centromere of the chromosome, we can call it as chromosomal fibers. Now coming to prometaphase. Here you can see this diagram clearly, prometaphase. A short stage, it is a short stage before metaphase, pro means before, and it is the stage after prophase. So, the stage between prophase and metaphase, there is a transition stage, a very short stage that is known as prometaphase. During this stage, chromosomes lie irregularly, see the diagram. Some are near the pole, some are in the middle, like that. The chromosomes are seen irregularly on the spindle fibers. Chromosomes are moving towards the equatorial plate of the cell. Equator, that means center of the cell. They started moving, but they have not reached the, some have reached even in the center and some are approaching, like that, irregular arrangement. Here you can see the next stage, that is metaphase. Chromosomes are highly condensed one, highly thick one, highly coiled one. You can see it clearly, even you can count it clearly also during this metaphase stage. They are highly condensed and thick one with a clearly the chromatids, each chromosome with the two distinct chromatids attached on the centromere position. So, you can identify it clearly and even you can count it also. Each of this chromosome, as I have already told you, with the two distinct chromatids. All the chromosomes, see what happens to their arrangement, where you can see exactly at the center of the cell, that is called as equatorial plate of the cell. So, this is the typical character of a metaphase stage, highly condensed, thick chromosomes with the distinct chromatids arranged at the equatorial plate of the cell. So, this particular character shows the typical character of a metaphase cell. Now, what happens to the spindle fiber regarding its formation? Spindle fiber formation is completed in this stage. Each chromosome that is connected by two chromosomal fibers. This is one chromosomal fiber starting from one pole, and this is the other chromosomal fiber that starts from the other pole. Each from each pole, and they are connected at the centromere part of the chromosome. Centromere of all the chromosomes, you observe, centromere of all these chromosomes, they lie in the center equator, equatorial plate. Now, the arms of the chromosomes are pointing towards the poles. Yet another identifying feature, centromere will be at the center or even equatorial plate of the cell and arms are pointing towards the poles. Now, coming to anaphase stage, here you can see the anaphase stage diagram. It is the shortest stage, which takes 2 to 3 minutes time. Spindle fiber that will contract. The contraction of a spindle fiber takes place. Now, what happens when the spindle fiber contracts? The centromere of each of the chromosome will divide. Centromere of each chromosome that will split, that will divide, and each chromatid will move to opposite poles. Here you can see the chromatids and these are the centromeres. So, it will move to opposite pole. The two sister chromatids, we will call it a sister chromatid. The two chromatids of the same chromosome, that we will call it as sister chromatid. Here also you can see the diagram clearly, or the chromatids, these chromatids are carried to opposite poles, not the entire chromosome as such. So, the chromosome with the two chromatid that will divide at the centromere portion, and it is moving to opposite poles here. The proteinaceous interzonal fibers, this is what is called as the interzonal fiber, and this interzonal fiber developed between the centromere of daughter chromosomes. Daughter chromosome means the separated chromatids. Centromere of each daughter chromosome, see the diagram, centromere of each of these daughter chromosome, that is pointing towards the poles. Now, what happens to the arms? Arms are pointing towards the center. So, this is the arrangement seen in the anaphase stage. So, this type of arrangement of chromosome and this particular stage, that is anaphase, and the arrangement, based on that arrangement we can identify the stage. So, centromere of each of the daughter chromosome or chromatids that points towards the poles, and arms are pointing towards the center, identifying characters. We can see equal number of chromosomes, daughter chromosomes in each of the pole. Here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 chromatids, or we can say daughter chromosomes. Here also you can see 4 chromatids or daughter chromosomes. So, in each pole we can see equal number of daughter chromosomes in this stage. Now, coming to the telophase stage. And during this stage, it takes around 1 hour to complete. It is just the opposite of prophase stage. The changes that takes place just opposite to the changes happened in the prophase stage. Chromosome starts uncoiling. You know, in prophase stage the chromosomes started coiling and condensation. Just the reverse, chromosomes starts uncoiling and decondensation. Then what we will get? We will get the thin chromatin threads. We will call it as chromatin reticulum. Now, what happens to these astral as well as the spindle fibers? That will disappear. Now, centrioles, that is surrounded by the centrosphere, the clear area, and forms centrosome, just opposite to that of prophase stage. Here you can see the diagram. In this particular diagram, telophase, nuclear membrane reappeared. During the prophase stage it starts disappear, and by the end of the prophase stage it is totally disappeared. Here it reappears. Now, you can see this blue colored structure, that is the nucleolus. So, this nucleolus also reappears. In prophase stage it disappeared, but here it reappears. And we can see one nucleus in each of the pole of the cell. Now, coming to the next stage. What is the next stage? Karyogenesis is over. Prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase, and the telophase. Now, what is the next stage of division? Yes, it is the cytokinesis. Cyto refers to cytoplasm. Kinesis means division. So, what is cytokinesis? Yes, it is the division of cytoplasm. Now, is there any change in the cytokinesis of an animal cell with that of a plant cell? Yes. In animal cell, it is by cell furrowing. The cell plasma membrane that produces a narrow ingrowth, invagination at the middle of the cell. And later, this particular invagination, ingrowth, that or the furrow that deepens and it meet together. And it will divide the cytoplasm into equally into two. Here you can see the same phenomenon of a cytokinesis, but it is in the plant cell. So, in animal cell it is by cell furrowing, invagination or furrow formation by the plasma membrane exactly at the center of the cell, furrow deepens, meets together and divides the cytoplasm equally into two. Here it happens by at another method that is known as cell plate formation. So, in plant cell the cytokinesis is by yet another method, that is by cell plate formation. Here you can see some of the fragments of endoplasmic reticulum, some of the vesicles from the Golgi bodies and the fragments of a spindle fibers, all these are arranged at the equator of the cell, arranged at the center of the cell in between the two nuclei. And these structures, these fragments, these pieces, they are collectively known as phragmoplast. We can say them as or call it as phragmoplast. And these phragmoplasts, they will fuse together and form the cell plate. All the components of the phragmoplast fuse together and forms the cell plate. It grows on both the sides and unite together and it will forms the middle lamella. Lamella means layer, middle layer. Later on, cellulose, hemicellulose and other molecules are deposited over this middle lamella and it will form the cell wall. So, by this method the cytoplasm of the cell that is divided into two equal components, parts. So, we will get two daughter cells, equally we will get two daughter cells. So, in short, the cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm in plant cell and in animal cell, there is difference. In animal cell it is by cell furrowing and in plant cell it is by cell plate formation. Now, why there occurs this mitosis? What is the need of this mitosis? What is the significance? What is its relevance, importance? So, it keeps the chromosome number constant in all the daughter cells. Suppose if it is 46, in the daughter cell also it will be 2n equals 46. It helps in growth and development of the zygote. You know, zygote is formed after fertilization, after syngamy, after the fusion of male and female gametes. It is only a single cell. Even though it contains two sets of chromosome diploid, it is only a single cell. We all developed from that single cell called as zygote. So, how it is possible? We are the multicellular complex organisms. How it is developed? How it is possible? The one and only option is by mitosis, the cell division. It helps in repair. If some of the tissues get damaged, if some injuries takes place, it must be healed up, it must be repaired, new and new cells must be added. So, for this purpose, there needs mitosis. And similarly, it helps in regeneration, regeneration of tissues from the lost parts. It helps in asexual reproduction, and similarly, it is restores nucleoplasmic ratio, the amount of or the ratio between nucleus and the cytoplasm, that is restored even in the daughter cell also as normal, equal. Now, see the differences between mitosis in the case of a plant cell and that of an animal cell. You see, plant cell, there won't be any centrioles. Centrioles are totally absent in plant cells, but it is present in the animal cell. And no astral formation, since centrioles are absent, no astral rays. Here asters are formed. Here you know cell plate is formed for cytokinesis. In animal cell, there won't be any cell plate formation. No cell furrowing. Here cytokinesis takes place by cell plate formation, not by cell furrowing. But in animal cell, no cell plate formation, it takes place by cell furrowing. In plant cell, no cell furrowing, but it takes place by cell plate formation. It occurs mainly in the meristems. Here occurs in tissues throughout the body. Now coming to meiosis, the second cell division, or rather we can say the third type of cell division. First one mitosis, then amitosis, then the third one, that is meiosis. Who discovered meiosis? You know, Van Benden discovered meiosis, and it was described by Winnie Water. The term meiosis that was coined by Farmer and Moore. It replaces in the reproductive, it takes place in the reproductive cells or even germ cells, pollen mother cells, megaspore mother cell. That means it takes place in the diploid cells. Meiosis is known as reduction division. Chromosome number is reduced to half in the daughter cells. Here, what are the changes takes place? Here also DNA must be duplicated. DNA duplicate only once, but the cell divides twice. Nucleus will also divides twice. Since it divides twice, we will get four daughter cells. It helps in sexual reproduction. It results in the production of haploid gametes, and it will maintain the chromosome number of a particular species constant in each and every generation. Now, I have already told you there are two stages of meiosis. One is nucleus divides twice in this stage, meiosis 1 or first nuclear division, and the other one is known as meiosis 2. So, here in meiosis 1, there occurs again karyokinesis, nuclear division followed by cytokinesis. Karyokinesis has different stages, prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. this one we are writing because it is the first nuclear division of meiosis. Now, here are some of the questions for you to think and answer. See, the first question: what is the average span of cell cycle in a mammalian cell? Distinguish cytokinesis from karyokinesis. Describe the events takes place during endophase. What is G0 of the cell cycle? Why is mitosis called as equational division? Name the stage of cell cycle in which the following events takes place. A. Chromosomes are moved to the spindle equator. Centromere splits and chromatids separate. How does cytokinesis of plant cell differ from that of an animal cell? Can there be mitosis without any DNA replication? Remaining aspects we will see in the second session. Thank you.